Welcome to the video again, and we will continue working on our project. Open and game.json. Make sure to open the game.json file which is in the repo folder which we made yesterday, and because this folder has the .git file in it, so it's connected to our GitHub repository. So now yesterday what we did was we made a damage system and damage animation for the player character, and let's test it out. So that's what we did. However, I want to show you one thing. If I remove this animation, that animation of ninja girl to idle jump, if I remove it, then the ninja girl will jump even higher. Right? So let's see why that is happening. So let me remove this. Delete. If you right click on any action or any condition, you will get this menu. From here you can delete, copy, cut or invert the condition or undo it. So I have deleted the animation, and now let's play it again. As you can see, ninja girl, it goes way up in the air. Did you see that? And so why should it happen? I mean, like, I just changed the animation, right? The object is the same, and we are applying the force to the object and not to the sprite, right? So even if I change the animation, it should still go high up in the air, because my impulse is, I mean my force is so high. I put it minus 100,000 on the y axis, so it will go very high up, and it does. But when I change the animation, it does not do that. It just goes, it just jerks up and then comes down. So I think we should understand it, because there may be a condition where we will have to achieve a certain effect using this concept. Like, when I change the animation, why is the force being changed as well? It may be a bug, but let's find out. So when I don't change the animation, it goes way up in the air. But if I change the animation, right, animation and images, change the animation by name, it was idle jump. Right. And on the left side, I think we should check for some condition which may be interfering with this. So there is this condition: if ninja girl is on floor and the animation of, then that's just animation thing, there is no force being applied or something. I will remove the touch control, because right now we are not using it. Can I not delete it? Well, looks like I can't delete it. Okay, whatever, let it be there. So if I change it to idle jump, it will not go as high up in the air as it used to. Let's see. You see that? He's just jerking up. That's the effect we want. That's the exact effect which we want. But why is that happening? I mean, I'm just changing the animation, I'm not doing anything else. So, and let me change the animation to something else. If I change the animation to throw, jump throw, then what will happen? The same thing happens. And idle, if I change it to idle, because he is idle right now, if I change the animation to idle, what will happen? He goes way up in the air. Because the animation has not changed at all. You know, I think what is happening here is that, and I'm not sure, you will have to, you know, confirm this with the developer of GDevelop 5, who is Forian. I will show you his GitHub today, but I think what is happening is that the force is being applied to the sprite and not to the object. So I think the force application function requires a sprite name, but when I am changing the animation, the sprite is being changed. It's a different sprite. It's not the same sprite. When the sprite image for the idle animation and the jump or any other animation are different, right? Because they are different files. So, and what I mean by that is, I think you can understand, it's a different file, right? And when I'm setting the animation to idle, it's not really changing the files, the animation files, right? So the force is, whatever force is being applied, it is working on it for as long as it should work. But when I'm changing the sprite, the force, I believe, is not being applied. Right, so if I don't apply this force, if I delete it, let me cut it so that I can put it back again. Let's see what. Okay, I have to change the animation also. This will not like right now. If I run it, nothing will happen. I mean, he will go translucent. Right, that's what is happening right now, and she is not being jerked up because we have removed the force. But if I change the animation to something else and idle jump and then I run it, then we will see the jerk effect, I believe. To see that he is jerking up. So what is happening here is that the animation is being changed, but as soon as the animation is being changed, this condition is played. Ninja girl is on floor and left mouse was released, not released, touch was not ended, right mouse was not released, and ninja and animation of ninja girl is not throw, then the animation is set to idle. So what is happening is that ninja girl is still on the floor, we are not making her jump, we are just changing her animation. When animation is changed momentarily for one frame, the next frame it is getting back to idle because we have put this condition here. And the control, I believe the control is flowing from up to down each frame. So when control flows from up to down, it checks this ninja girl is on floor, okay, set animation to idle, cool. And then it comes down, then it checks has a ghost collided with ninja girl, and if it has, then it will change the animation to idle jump momentarily, in the next frame it will run this run these instructions again, right? So and then again it will check, is Ninja Girl on floor? Then yes, she is still on floor. Is the animation not throw? Yes, the animation is not throw, it is idle jump. So this condition is true. So then it will again, then it will set the animation to idle. So what is happening is that her animation is being changed when she is getting hit. It is being changed to idle jump. Let me show you how idle jump looks like. It looks like this. Okay, it looks like this. Her animation is being momentarily changed from idle to idle jump, and so it looks like she is jerking, right? No force is being applied. We are just changing the animation. So, but I think this is a bug, that if you apply the force to an object and you can change the animation, then that force will not be applied. I think that's kind of a bug or something. So I think we should take notice of this. And so if you want to achieve the jerking effect, you don't have to apply a force. You can just change the animation to something else, which is a little more dramatic, and it will automatically achieve the jerk effect. So that was the confusion yesterday. So we have cleared it. Now let us proceed to do something else. So yeah, he's being jerked up, he and the health is being decreased. I noticed that the health is also going to becoming negative, right? We don't want that to happen. As soon as the health reaches zero, we have to show a game over screen, but we have to do that after showing the dead animation of the girl, right? So health is zero, girl will die. We have to show that she is dying. We can't just immediately switch the screen and write on top of it game over. That's bad, that's not good, right? So we have to show that she is being animated and like dying. We have dying animation, we have to run that animation. And while that animation is running, we have to ignore all the controls. We don't have to register any control. So I think we have something which can achieve that. So let us create a new empty event and add condition. Condition is very simple, variable, value of a global variable. Global variable is health, and if its value is less than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 0. If you put equal to 0, that is correct, but it will not work because it's not necessary that her value goes from 10 to 0. It can go from 10 to minus 20 and then never reach 0. I mean it will never be 0. It can be minus 2, it can be minus 20, that it can be 2, or it can be minus 10. That can also happen. And your condition is being checked every frame. What if one frame your health is 10 and then some ghost attacks you and makes your health minus 20, and then your health is minus 20, right? Minus 20 in the next frame, so it never reaches 0. So don't use equal to, use less than or equal to, because any health, whether it is 0 or it is minus something, it's a condition where we should show the game over screen. So click on OK, and that's the condition, our condition. And so we need to do something here, add action, right? First thing what we should do is platform behavior, ignore default controls options, maximum speed platforms, no. There is one way to do it, which is kind of not very conventional, I believe. But if If I create another sprite, but then let me do that. That will be a cleaner way to do things. Let me do it. Ninja girl, I will make another sprite which will be the just the dying animation, dead animation of the ninja girl. Let me create a new object. I think you can't see it. Yeah, now you can see it. You should go to add a new object, and then you should add a sprite, new object, and the name of the sprite is ninja girl dying. Right, add an animation. We have to add a dying animation, add, and ninja girl png dead. So dead 0 to dead 9, dead 9 open, and our speed should be 0.033. Right, so this is good, and she will not have any behaviors or anything really. Yeah, no behaviors. Apply, and let me do some resizing. What is her size? Width 113 and height 213. What is this girl's width and height? It should be the same, right? Almost. I can't edit her width and height from here, it looks like. Can I edit these with Pixel? I'm sure I... Oh, I can. This is really cool. I can edit an imported animation with Pixel, which is so cool. It's amazing. Our width and height are too much, and I want to resize. What was it again? I will not do it right now. Wait, what is the width and height? 113 and 213. So let's do that. Resize her. Oh no, yeah. No, wait. Let's do it this way only. Let's first test it out if it's working or not. Wait, let me first. Yeah, so let's see. Global variable is held less than equal to 0. Add action. What I will do is I will delete an object, which is ninja girl. I will delete ninja girl. So all the controls related to ninja girl will not work. And now I will add a sprite. Okay, before deleting, I think I should add the sprite. I think I should store the location of ninja girl. I can do that, and let's do that. Let's do it. Global variables. Layer X, it's something. Right now I'll just put 0, but it's not 0. Layer Y, 0, it's not 0. And what is it? It is 30 and 970. So let's put 30 and 970. 30, 970. Right, so we now have saved the initial location of the player, and now we have it saved. So I can now delete the ninja girl. I deleted ninja girl, and then what I will do is I will now Create an object. Create an object from its name. Integral dying. Oh no. Create an object. Just create an object. Don't click create an object from its name. Click create an object. Integral dying. X position is variables, global variable, and the position is player X. And Y position is, you can just copy this and paste here and just put Y in place of X. Oh, it's capital Y. Layer, pawn layer. Pawn layer. Or base layer. Let's choose base layer. Let's see what happened. Base layer. And yeah. But I know that the size of the Ninja Girl dying animation is bigger than the Ninja Girl. So let's see what happens. Really. And in order to run it faster, I will have to increase the frequency of ghosts. Right, I want to increase how fast the ghosts are coming. How do I do that? I think we have a scene variable. This can do that. Number of ghosts on screen. It should be. It's 0 right now. Why is it 0? Oh yeah, this one is just to keep track of the ghost. I think it's a global variable. Which means total number of ghosts on screen, it is 3. I will make it 30. Right, so that I have 30 ghosts screen at a time. That will be too much, 10 ghosts. So that her health reduces faster, so that we can test it. He is gone, but where is the new sprite? I can't see the new sprite anywhere. It should have been here. Do I have to play the animation also? Ninja Girl dies, but the new one doesn't come. Let me first increase the total number of ghosts on screen to 30. And one more thing. I think the speed of the ghost is also a very important variable, which I think I should give different ghosts their own speeds. Right, so where have we used how fast the ghost is moving? We have used it here. Add to ghost or white a permanent force of -600. This -600 should not be a static value. It should be a variable which should depend on the type of ghost. Right, so to do that, let's just click on these three dots and open edit object variables. Now I will also add one more thing, which is speed, which is right now for this ghost -600, right? And now wherever I added the force here, it shouldn't be a value, it should be a variable. Object variable, which object? Ghost orb variable speed fly. So now the speed of the ghost is also variable, which we can change. Let me change it to something more so that our simulation can run faster and the girl can die faster, and so we can test it faster. what is going wrong. Ninja girl dying is not coming, so I will play the animation as well. Sprite, animation, change the animation, ninja girl dying, and the animation name is dying. Okay, save it and let's run it. He just disappears, but the new one doesn't come. Why is that happening? Maybe our position is not correct. Global variable player X, player Y. Create an object at specified position. X is 30 and Y is 970. Base layer. Oh, maybe she is being spawned in the base layer and her Z order value is very low. Let me spawn her on the spawn layer. Spawn layer. Okay. Let's test it. Okay, so many of them are being spawned because the health is less than zero and is being, you know, yeah. So we have to spawn it only once. So should we add a variable? We should add it. I mean, there is no other way of doing it. So there may be, but I don't know about it. So let me add a, you know, counter, just a boolean variable, not really boolean, but we will consider it a boolean. Has died. Is that good? Zero, which means he has not died yet. Right, and in the events we will check this condition also. Has she died. Variable is has died, operator is equal to zero. Here I am doing equal to but, and there is actually a logic behind choosing equal to and less than equal to or greater than equal to, and that logic is if you are changing the value of some variable in the code, then you can choose equal to, strictly equal to. But if the user is changing the value, or the value is being changed not by you but by your program, you know, I mean, like in this case the value is being changed by the ghost, which is a part of our program, but we don't know whether it will not do what it will not do this. That is, it can make the health value jump from 10 directly to -5, right? And then it will not go to 0. So our condition will fail. That's the logic. So global variable has died is 0. Then she will die and play the dying animation. And I will change the value of the variable to 1. Can die has died variable. Has died. One. He has died. So it will not be played again. So let's test it. However, let me decrease the speed again of the ghost. So I have clicked on these three lines of the ghost. Edit, and let me just keep it back to 600. Because when it's too fast, they are just going through her because her cooldown is not getting completed. Is it too slow? Okay, wait. It will take a lot of time. Let me change her health to health to 10. So one ghost will kill her. That will yes, died. Yes. Our sprite is yes, died and once, but our sprite is too big and it's out of position. So what we have to do is resize our sprite, and the size of this sprite is 113 and cross 213 custom size. So let me resize the sprite size. Scale Ninja Girl Dying. Oh, not scale. Let me just put the height. Ninja Girl Dying to 11. Sorry, this is the width, right? 113 width. 113. No, 113 is not the width. 113 is the height. No, sorry. 117 is the height. Yeah. 217. Two one three height. Let me do one more thing. Wait, I'm just wanting to see what is the width of the Ninja Girl Dying when I set the height to 213. So let's double click on it to open it. Edit with Pascal. And there it is. And if I change her height to 213, width is 206. Change the width to 206. Okay, this should work. Let's see if it does. And let me reorder this. Reorder. Let's let it be like this. Dying animation is being played. I think she becomes smaller, right? She becomes smaller and we should fix that. Just change her retinite. So let me change our width to 113. What will be our height? I mean, in the Ninja Girl Dying animation. It will be even smaller. Do we have to do some guesswork? Right now her height is 213, so she is looking smaller. What if her height is 250? Let's try that. Width will be 241. So let's try. And width 241. Well, most of the time what we will do is, because our Ninja Girl sprite was bigger, the source. We have to resize it, and we have to fiddle with it a little bit. I have to do it, but since like this, so let's do it this way. Perfect. And my computer is not working. So we have done this, and her size is also not very variable. It looks almost same. You don't have to really measure it because it should look same. Let's see it again. I think she will once more. So yeah, it's working, right? So I don't think it looks good. It looks okay. So now I just want to get some game over screen, right? I change the screen, or I can get game over of it. But when we write it, when the dying animation has finished playing and the player has gotten the time to realize that their character has died. So we have to do it that way. There it is. And make a game over text. But first we have to make a text. And to do what we have to do is go to this plus sign, click on plus, click on text, click on game, type game over text. Font should be just the default system font. If you have a good font, you can use that. Size should be, I think 100, no, 50, 100, 200, let's keep it at 200. Text to display, game over. Keep it all caps, game over. Color white and bold. Okay, and apply. And now we should do some coding. Now you can go to this events and click on add an event, empty event, add condition. So when should we play it? When the animation has finished. When the animation of Ninja Girl dying is finished, the game over screen will game over text will appear. Text object. Should I just no common action object create an object game over text X position Y position. What should this be? I think it should be the middle of the screen. But what is the middle of the screen? I think do we have some variable for that screen? Height of the scene window, width of the scene window. Width of the scene window. Width of the scene window upon 2 And height of the scene window upon 2, will that work? Let's see. Scene window height upon 2. Layer on layer. It can work, may work. Let's see if it does. Yeah, it does, but kind of x y is good, but x is, oh yeah, okay, the origin of our text object is at this corner, right? Suppose this is a text object, which it is, its origin is right here at this corner. So when we are putting the position as width of the screen by 2, which is midway, so the game engine is putting this point in the middle, so that's why it's appearing that way. So what we have to do is just put 0, or just put, you know, 0 is good, because if we put scene window width, then it will be all the way to the, you know, right, which we don't want. So we will put 0. I hope that works. Let's see. Works. It's kind of not in the center. It's kind of not in the center. It should be. And how do I make it come to the center? I can hard code it, but we don't want that to happen. I know the width of the screen, which is something, and if I half it, I will find the middle point, right? And then I want the width of the text field itself, right? And then subtract half of that width from this point, from this position, so I will get an ideal position. Let's see if I can do that. Scene window height by 2, so I got the midpoint. Now minus width of some object, size width of game over text, game over text width, which is a lot, by 2. What will this do? First thing, what it will do is that it will give me scene window height, sorry, not height, it should be width, scene window width, right, which is, it will give me a point location of the point, which is all the way to the right, and I will half it, so I will reach in the middle. And but now if I make the text appear in the middle, it will appear, it the origin of the text will be in the middle, and the rest of the text will be towards the right. But this, I have to take this point and subtract half of the width of my game over text, so that my origin comes a little bit towards the left, right? And let's test it out. Let's test it. Well, it's not working for some reason, and many game over texts are being created. Okay, why is it not working? If I subtract this whole thing, then what will happen? Let's try. Working. Let me check if there are many instances being created. So I am going to hard code it because it should work, but it's not working, and I don't want to waste a lot of time on this. Just a little bit right, not zero, maybe 50. And we will also keep it modular. I will make a variable, because hard coding that can be a bad idea. I'll make a variable game over x position, which is 50. In this case, in the case of this screen, it is 50. I will try to fix this maybe tomorrow and keep it dynamic. Invert x position, apply, okay, save and test it for one last time. Game over. And she dies very fast. Let me slow that animation. Yes, that's that better. Good enough. I just double clicked on Ninja Girl dying. So I just double clicked on it, and that's how I get this window. So if you can't see it, you should consider that I'm double clicking on these. And when I want to change the variable, I will just click on these three dots and edit object variable, and now I can change the variable. That's how it is. So yeah, that's what we did today. I think that's enough for one day. Now let us go and push these changes on our Git repository. So this Git folder, which is in my case Soul Hunter Downtown repo, the new one, and right click, open Git bash here, and now type git status. We change two files, game.json, game.json.autosave, which was changed by gdevelop itself. Now git add dot git commit minus m make game over system, make game over system, git push origin master. So it has pushed all the changes to our GitHub repository. Let me check it. there it is, make game over system, and we posted it just now a minute ago. So that's how you can manage your code. So yeah, that's it for today. If you enjoyed this, join me again tomorrow. Thank you for watching.